check left, reversing light. So that's the, and then check rear fog light. To check that engine management light wasn't for anything, so we'll stick it in reverse. Right, just go and have a look. So I knew it was out. That's what we're left with. Let's go forward. So we need to try and sort that out. God knows. So now that we've found the issue, the clusters are wired towards the centre, and then both come down back. Sorry, down inside this hinge. It's all the same. I don't know if you'll be able to see it or not. I think that's the wires there. So when the door, the boot closes, it's moving the wires, and there's obviously damage in the cabling. Because not only do we not have a reverse light, now we don't have either side light and a fog light. So, going to need to pull this off, which is, there was a clip there which I managed to break. It was just a nightmare, struggled to get it off. There's a clip, it was up. Let me see. Up around. Yeah. Which was a nightmare to get out. I had no doubt there'd be a couple kicking about somewhere, so I'm going to lift the carpet. I need to pull this trim, get that out, or at least enough to get to the wires, and then I'm going to need to strip the wires. And then cut out the damaged section and resolder the rest together. So, I suppose I better go on with it. I don't know if you can see this, but this is clipped on here, and you can see it when the opening closes. Moving this whole bit of wire in here, right round. So we need to unclip. So at first glance, even before we strip it, see if we to exposed conductors. State of that, if it focuses. Absolute mess. It's quite just a lot harder. Oh, sorry. It's actually parted completely. So I'm going to need to connect them up and try and hopefully it's just the two. If it's just those two, then should be able to. Oh, is it able, like 1, 2, 3? So I can identify them. Mess. A penny or something.
know if you can see this or not properly, but I'm in the boot. So I ended up putting some insulating tape around them, each connection, or each shrink, crimped the connection anyway. They were bunched up so close to put the heat gun on them, it was just too difficult to control, which was getting heat and it was starting to melt some of the insulation on the cable, so I didn't heat shrink all of them. As you can see here, this one here, I just left a set of it, I've wrapped each side where it wasn't heat shrink. Just some belts and braces hopefully. So I've clipped it on them, stuck in a boot here, just to see how it looks when it's closing. Clipped it back on, I've put some tape around where the points that was moving most, and I've taped this here and taped it down the back onto the other side of this internal part of the rear ring. And I can kind of see how it's going to. It's just this part here that was moving heaps anyway. There's not much I can do with that. See if I can get you back here. But that's going to move no matter what. So the reason I've taped that out is to try and minimise any movement, or as much as possible up here. I'll maybe stick some more tape, but to be honest, there's not much extra I could probably do. They obviously used to go in here, but they won't go there now because of the connections, so there's not much else I can do there. Still a bit of movement on it, but at least where the movement is, it's been taped up, so hopefully that minimises. I'll put my tape around here just because, and hopefully that will minimise any stress on individual pieces. You know, if it moves as a collective, then should be okay, and probably we'll see it out for well before, long after I get rid of the car anyway, so. So let's just check that everything's still working before I put the panel back on.